Hey guys, what's up? In this video, we're going to take a look at some terminal commands. So let's start with just opening terminal real quick. So we'll do this. You could use terminal for, you know, some fun things. If we typed in SL, for instance, this brings across this like some little train locomotion animation, which is kind of fun. You could use it for, you know, checking things like if you're into Bitcoin or something like that. You might want to see what your Bitcoin's doing today. This is provided by another developer who conveniently created this to do so. So that's not built in. The SL one also is not built in as well. So if you want to see how that works, there is a separate video and that will get you caught up. And I'll leave some steps and directions for you guys to follow along. But yeah, there's lots of fun things you can do with terminal. You can even use terminal to say a command or have it speak to you for accessibility or just say something. So we'll say wake up, Kevin. It's time to leave the matrix. Sorry about that. So
wake up, Kevin. It's time to leave the matrix.
So that's interesting. You can have it say different things. We'll just clear this for now. But I mean, those are fun and nice to use. You know, if you really wanted to, like, say, see the matrix, you say see matrix. And it's not like the matrix, but it gives you, you know, a pretty fun screensaver representation of matrix. You can exit that by hitting escape or control C, and that'll get you back out. And once again, C matrix is something that I installed using Homebrew. So be sure to check out that video on how to install Homebrew. So those are fun commands and they're nice. And there's different things you can do, like check the weather, there's date, there's calendar, like CAL brings up your calendar and different things. And I'll try to walk you through why you may want to use or reach for the command line versus using the GUI. There are some advantages to both. And it just depends on when and where and what you're doing and what your workflow is. So we'll start with an easy one. It'll be PWD and it's print working directory or current directory. And once you do that, you'll see that is the current directory that we're currently in. It's also displayed up here. A common one is CD. If you're not familiar with that by now, it's basically change directory. Let's say we type in CD like we have here and we'll use the tilde sign, which represents home, and we'll start typing D. And if you hit the tab button, you'll notice that it gives you a bunch of options like where you want the CD into based on the text that you've typed in. So in this case, I want to go to the desktop. So if I start typing DES and I get desk and I hit tab again, it'll auto complete for me. So that nicely took me to the desktop by PWD. If you want to validate that inside of say Finder, open, and it will open up Finder. And you will see that I'm in my Macintosh under users, williamsk, and I'm at the desktop. So this representation is pretty much the same as what you would see in the, you know, the GUI version. Alternatively, you could use Spotlight and type in Finder. And depending where your default directory is for Finder, the one that you chose to open up, you'd end up in the same place or wherever you chose. Okay, and we kind of segued a little bit there, but let's just jump back to CD. So if you CD just by itself and you hit enter, you can check your present working directory. That takes you right back to your home. A lot of people would like to type CD and the tilde. That's exactly the same thing. Another command that we'll learn right now is clear. And when you type this, it will remove all the contents that are visibly displayed in this current window, like this session that you can see. And if you wanted to navigate up or down into a directory, you do this by using CD. And I'll show you this right now. We'll just jump in. And in this case, I'm going to use a lowercase version versus the uppercase version. I'm going to tab. And notice how it doesn't give me the auto completion. If I type in desktop, it's smart enough to know that, you know, I want to go here. And notice that the desktop is in lowercase. So I always try to, you know, match the case if you can, but it won't, you know, hold you hostage or anything like that. It'll let you go where you need to go depending on what you're typing and how you type it. So if we wanted to, like, you know, navigate back up a directory, we'd say CD dot dot. And where does that put us? So PWD, it took us from desktop and it went up one. So from desktop, we went up one and we went to williamsk. So if we PWD, essentially, we're in the root again. We're back to, you know, the equivalent, which is CD tilde, right? Or CD. And if we PWD, we're in the same place. So sounds confusing, but I hope you were paying attention to that. And it's just multiple ways to get to the same thing. So CD allows you to get back to your root directory. CD tilde, home directory, same thing. If you do a double period, it's the parent directory of wherever you are, you know, you'll go up. And then we'll also learn a few other basics in the next segment. I'll see you in that one.